And so we gather together today to commend Dorothy to God's care and see when we love not a moment of our life is lost. It's a perfect gift to God when we offer one of his creatures, Dorothy, to the Father today, just as Jesus offered his life. He said, "This is my body given up for you, and this is my blood that is poured out for you." And then Jesus will say, "You are my beloved. Come." And that God would receive Dorothy already into that blessed union with the angels and saints forever, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Jim, as he adjusts to life now without her, for the family, as they too adjust, that God strengthen his wisdom and the Lord will be with them in the days ahead, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And the next one of us to die, that we might be prepared with the life of faith and good works, to come before God and hear him say, "Come, beloved of the Father," we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us add our other intentions in quiet. O God, how precious is the life of any of your people. And today we offer Dorothy to you. Help us as we gather to do this, to offer you our fitting praise, our love, and our thanks for her life and her goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The prayer of St. Francis, 495. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never see so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves
given and human hands have made, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink. Let us pray, my friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his church.
Amen. O Lord, may this offering help our sister Dorothy, for by this sacrifice you take away the sins of the world. Bring her now into the company of the angels and saints. We ask through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give you thanks and praise.
Father, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus. In him who rose from the dead, our hope of resurrection dawned. The sadness of death gives way to the bright promise of immortality. Lord, for your faithful people, life has changed, not ended. And when the body of our earthly dwelling lies in death, we gain an everlasting dwelling place in heaven. And so with the choirs of angels, we proclaim your glory, and we join in their unending hymn of praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna.
Father, you are holy indeed, and all creation rightly gives you praise. All life, all holiness comes from you. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, by the working of the Holy Spirit. From age to age, you gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a perfect offering may be made to the glory of your name. And so, Father, we bring you these gifts. We ask you to make them holy by the power of your Spirit, that they might become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus. On the night before he died in love, he gathered with his disciples. He took bread from the table. He gave it to them and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you."